Okay, so I went ahead and built a couple of more NPC houses. And the next thing that we're gonna be doing is I think I'm gonna attempt the Eater of Worlds. I just wanna take a look if I can tank him with the claws. Basically, like the Eater of Worlds was one of the hardest bosses in death mode, believe it or not. Like when it compared to when you have to fight him. He was such an insane pain, it took me like 20 tries just to kill him. So I wanna go ahead and try if I can maybe tank him. Maybe I can skip the boss because it's way too difficult. But when I'm already tanking, I obviously need my potions. So let's go ahead and buy those. I need Iron Skin to tank, Endurance, Regen. Thorns potion is also useful, and that should be about it. So basically, his head does 80 damage, I think, when it hits. And he can spit cursed flames every like 3 seconds, and those cursed flames do a lot of damage as well. So fighting him in the underground corruption without like mining it, which obviously doesn't work, so without bombing it, it's gonna be one hell of like a torture basically. So hopefully I can avoid it by just using the claws, like I once did. For that however I need the spark, for sure, so I'm gonna be replacing the... Yeah, most likely I'm gonna be replacing Clouds in a Bottle for now. This one went down into the corruption, okay. Oh, did it? Yeah, it did. Okay, so I didn't show it, but for some reason when the meteorite landed in my last episode, it destroyed a shadow orb out of nowhere. I think it landed on top of one then, otherwise obviously it doesn't make any sense. So the next shadow orb will summon him indeed. So let's go. Yeah, I'm gonna fight him up there. Like, I'm legit praying that we can tank him. I do not want to fight him legit again, that was way too hard. Plus I even had meteorite to pierce, which I don't have in this playthrough. Right, guess the shadow orb has to be it then. Oh man, I'm really not looking forward to this. This should be enough. Where is he coming from? Here, hook into the ground and then let's go. This might work. Please. Oh, he does so much fucking damage. Already had to heal once. No! It was only 2 parts left, are you kidding me? Oh my god, okay. But you know what? I should have enough to make the Shadow Scale armor, so I can just go ahead and basically make the Shadow Scale armor, then tank it, and then I should be able to survive. Thank god this works. Like, holy shit, I do not have the nerves to do him again. Oh yeah, this is what I was talking about. So basically the meteorite landed down here, meaning that it destroyed a Shadow Orb. That's why I only had to destroy one. I've never had that before, because like, imagine how big the chances are. But it's pretty cool. Alright, so before I do anything, I'm gonna make sure that I have full HP. I'm also gonna go ahead and make it so that I can't get attacked from anything else. Where should I do it? I should do it here. I'm gonna go ahead and place some spiky bolts though, to make it easier. Not again. I did it, okay. That was so close. Holy fuck, was this close. Okay. We cheesed him, guys. We did it. I feel like I'm, you know, no offense, man. That's just a joke, okay? Alright, so we got the worm scarf, perfect. Holy shit, that was intense. I had like 10 HP or something and he was close to hitting me again when I killed him. Oh well, so I can make the entire armor set now. Which gives us way more defense and 15% increased movement speed. And besides that, I can also make the pickaxe, so I can finally farm meteorite. Unhappy nightmare pickaxe, yeah, thanks. The thing is, it's not even worth it anymore to farm, like, meteorite now. Maybe for the bullets, but I'm using the fungicide either way, so, like, it doesn't matter, to be honest. Okay, so upcoming is a speed build of me building a new base, because for some reason I felt the urge to build, so I went ahead and did it. Right away I'm gonna say I sheeted the palm wood and the boreal wood, but that's about it, the rest was done legit. I mean, I talked about it before. I'm not gonna start the discussion again. Just live with it. That's basically it. Enjoy the speed build after that. The episode continues. Alright, so welcome back. Since the last clip that you've just seen, or since my speed build basically, it's been like 2 days. I recorded too much, so I left out a bit of for the last episode. That's why there was no, like, thanks for watching at the end. So this is just basically continuing the last episode. This might be a bit longer than usual, because I have 8 minutes from the last episode left, so I don't know, like, this will most likely be around 30 minutes instead of 20. But I think no one will mind, so yeah, whatever. Basically, I wanted to show you my house that I built in the speed build, like the finished version. It's not completely finished, obviously, but as far as it goes right now. And it looks really amazing, like I'm a big fan of the building. It's still a bit empty in here. Obviously, I'm gonna fill that with trophies and such if I get them. Item frames also, most likely. And I built the storage unit here. However, I do not have enough demonites to fill everything, which means I'm gonna be farming the Tough Worlds. I mean, we all know how easy it is with those claws. So I'm gonna be buying a couple of tank potions, worm food, and then I'm just gonna like tank him for a couple of times. How did he get in here? And when we have enough to make the entire thing there, the entire like construction full, then I'm gonna go ahead and attempt my hive mind, which will be an absolute torture. I think I'm gonna do him over here because it's pretty flat. I might do this, like remove this and make it even flatter. But hive mind will be a torture, like the death mode version is so hard. But yeah, for now I'm gonna go ahead, buy some ammunition, some potions, worm food, and then we're good to go. We're also gonna farm a bit of money while doing it. So it doesn't hurt. And I can go ahead and farm the meteorite soon to get meteorite bullets. But right now I'm too lazy for that. Or like, I mean, we're gonna be in the corruption anyways, so I'm just, yeah, I can just do it basically. Wait. I didn't put the... Okay, my bad. I didn't put her here. For some reason, like, I remember putting her here, but for some reason... Okay, that's weird. Oh yeah, by the way, this is what our old house looks like. I removed it with T-Edit. Poor thing. So wait, where is she? She moved in the house now? Oh, what a fucking bitch, like holy shit, I walk all the way and then she... Oh my god. Wow, just wow, man. By the way, I'm really glad to see that you guys enjoy the like new editing style and the new playthrough so much. Like, the feedback is absolutely amazing. So I'm glad to see that. I put a lot of work into my new playthroughs editing style, basically. And seeing that you guys enjoy it, that really makes me happy. I mean, the feedback has been amazing, and like the like-dislike ratio in the comments just goes to show that uploading less actually works, because I put more quality in and you guys seem to appreciate it more. Oh, here we go. Yeah, that's torture. I don't think... I'm not gonna do them here. I'm gonna do the things that I wanted to do before I attempt them. But like, Hive Mind is gonna be brutal. If you've seen my Death Mod All Bosses video, you know what I mean? Like, I think the second phase from him has like 11k HP, plus the teleports. It's nuts. It took me way too many tries, and I think this will also take a lot of tries. Hopefully I can kill him first try though. I wanna keep the death counter low. Alright, so I'm gonna throw some spiky bolts down. Then put this again. Also gonna put this because, I mean, I'm just sitting around. So I'm gonna hook into the ground, take my potions, worm food, and let's go. Yeah, okay, we take way less damage. Like, this should be easy, basically. Oh, like, guaranteed. I mean, it's easy. You know what I mean. Oh, it's actually getting kinda close. I'm just gonna heal to make sure I don't die. Well, yeah, that's it, okay. So I'm gonna have to wait until I regen. I feel like after my playthrough this is gonna get buffed. Or like, I mean, this is gonna get disabled, at least in death mode. Maybe the Eat of Worlds parts, don't drop hearts anymore. That might be a way to fix it. I just feel like it, because the death is watching. Which would be sad, but I mean, I used it to farm. That's just... it's gonna be bad for you, not for me, okay? Alright, let's open the treasure bags. I mean, that might be enough already. Alright, here we go. 800 items, that should be enough. Oh my god, I'm a fucking idiot, I still didn't mine the meteorite. Okay, so I'm pretty sure this is enough. At least for like, I don't know, the next 20 playthroughs. Okay, so let's go ahead and search a hive mind. Or hive sized, or whatever it's called. While I'm doing this, I'm just gonna go ahead and make a platform around this entire area, so that I have flat ground. Oh, here we go, there's one already. Okay guys, ready for the first fail? Okay, this has to be enough. At least for the first attempt, because I don't want it to despawn. Oh man, I'm really not looking forward to this. I'm gonna start off by throwing like, I don't know, 20 fucking... Yeah, what's it called again? Spiky balls down there? So when it spawns, it takes an insane amount of damage. Okay, I took my potions and here we go. Oh my sh- there's no way we just did it first try. Holy shit, man. I expected to, I don't know, like take 10 attempts or something and we did it first try. Wow, I was fucking shaking at the end. Okay. So yeah, we did it. He dropped quite a lot of shit. The Hive Mind Mask is kind of funny, I think we're gonna... Never mind. Then we got the Rotten Brain. I mean, it's kind of useful, but I don't have any space for it at the moment. I mean, I could replace... Okay, I'm gonna do it. Because once we find the goblin, I don't need the clot in a bottle anymore. Alright, so this is gonna be jungle. The enemies will do 40% more damage and the spawn rate is constantly boosted. This sounds like fun. It's not like jungle is like cancer enough. Okay, you just seen me basically teleport back and disable my spawn. That has a reason, I'm not gonna talk about it though. Like, it's supposed to be a surprise, you will see it. But I had to prepare it, so basically just wait a little and you will see what I why I did it. It's gonna be worth the waiting, trust me. Okay, so following. First of all, I found the biggest diamond, what's it called? Like, I know the German word right now, but not the English word. Basically, I found the, like, biggest amount of diamonds. This is like 20 diamonds in just a single place. I've never had this before. Oh, is it 20? Yeah, it's around 20. 19. And below it, I found a hive. Alright, so now I'm gonna show you why I reset my spawn. So basically, there's a bug that you can abuse, and since this is death mode, I'm gonna be doing it. So if you go below the beehive, throw a bomb below it, and then teleport back to spawn, and it destroys, she, Queen Bee will spawn where you are at the moment. That's why I reset the spawn. So we will fight Queen Bee. Guess you didn't expect that, right? So yeah, death mode Queen Bee is absolute crazy, in case you don't know. Like, she spams a million of those stingers. Alright, okay. That didn't work out. At least I'll show you the trick. Basically, like, I should prepare an arena before I do this, because it's still death mode. That was my bad. You've seen how crazy she is, like, it's amazing. This fight is absolutely nuts. But yeah, I feel like I used the tree in order to get rid of her spikes, because otherwise yeah, there's no way you're gonna get past the spikes. But it didn't quite work out. I also shouldn't leave the tree, that was my bad. So I'm gonna search another hive and then I'm gonna make a cut. And while doing it, I'm just gonna go ahead and prepare a couple of those things here. So I can block off the spikes. Like, for some reason, even though I knew exactly what's about to happen, I don't know, it felt like I was unprepared, I don't know why. Doesn't make much sense, yeah, but it felt like it. Okay, this is one weird... Okay, this looks completely wrong. I mean, this, yeah, it's fine, it's fine. I have, shouldn't do that. Alright, let's go. Next attempt. Alright, there we go. These walls really work amazingly against her. Did she drop anything else? No, she didn't, okay. So yeah, like I said, it works amazingly against her. I did not expect this to go this well, basically. Like, the spike spam is amazing. Oh, what? Like, her spike spam is way too crazy, like you've seen it. So, without using this trick, if you wanna call it, it's nearly impossible. Also, the bomb glitch, or like, bug that I've used, it's like, obviously it's a bug, but like, you just have to consider I could do the same by just grinding the spawner, then spawning her and then teleporting back to home. Or I could basically just go ahead and build a flat jungle with T-Edit and then make it there, like in my video basically. So it just sped things up once again. It wasn't like anything major. Of course it made it easier, but still, like I said. Alright, so let's go back home. We still didn't find the goblin though. Unfortunately, but episode 3 and we already killed Queen Bee. Like, I need to chill down. I need to chill. This is still death mode. I don't know why those things just go as fluently as they do. Alright, so I do not need anything except for... Yeah, basically I don't need anything. So... Hive pack, hive, yeah, okay, we only got shit. Well, whatever. Like, we got one platinum out of it. We should be at like 3 platinum already. Let's take a look, maybe even 4. 3.5, that's more than enough. Oh yeah, and I'm gonna take all of these strange plants out of here. I have quite a lot. Okay, we only got blue acid twice and negative dye. Negative dye is disgusting. Okay, blue acid looks cool, actually. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that for now. Alright, but yeah, enough action in one episode. We already killed fucking how many bosses? 7 bosses in 3 episodes? And it's death mode? Alright, yeah, I need to calm down. This is too crazy right now. But yeah, thanks for watching. This time I'm actually gonna end the episode here, no matter how long it is. So it might be like a 40-minute episode even if that's, this is too long, but I think it's gonna stay at like 30, I don't know. I'm gonna build the NPC houses real quick and then, yeah, see you in the next episode and thanks for watching.